pour that in and get it stirred up good. And then you'll be ready to add 2 egg yolks. You don't add the whole egg, just the yolk. You can also use an egg separator if you want to, if you're not used to doing it this way. And you stir it up once more, and then it's just about ready to go on. You'll put it on the stove top and cook it at medium until it thickens. And it will take a little while. So we'll move over here to the stove. Now this seems like it'll take forever to thicken. You do not want to quit stirring, because when it does decide to thicken, it does it quickly and it'll set on and scorch really bad. It'll ruin the whole thing. So you just keep stirring. Now if you wanted to forego doing this, you could also use any kind of a vanilla pudding. You could use a Bavarian cream filling. You know, anything that you would like to use that's, you know, like a pudding type substance. This is a cream filling. It has a slightly more egg flavor, not quite as sweet. The sweetness is going to come from the strawberries.
Nope.
Now don't be discouraged, because this does take quite a long time and your hand can easily get tired. But once it starts foaming up good and it's almost thick, you go ahead and add the butter and it'll melt into it. Okay, it's starting to thicken now, and this is where you got to be real careful. I always turn it off when it gets about this spot. Pull it off. And whip it fast and hard. And that's about the consistency it should be. Nice and smooth texture, but pretty thick. Then after it's done cooking, you add 1 teaspoon of vanilla. I'm not exact about it, and I've been known to do a little bit more than 1 teaspoon because I love vanilla. And you stir it in. Okay, our first crusts are done. I bring it out, put the next one in. You'll want to wait for your cream filling to cool. You'll stir it every once in a while to keep it from forming a crust at the top. While it's cooling, we'll finish our strawberries here. What you want to do now is go ahead and take a masher, and you just want them nice and mashed. That'll continue to bring out more of this juice. Now, I don't say how much sugar to add, because how sweet you want it's going to depend on your taste. So I just sweeten it to my taste. The sugar helps it to form like a syrup. Now we have the cream filling done and cooled, all 3 of the pie crusts done and cooled, and we have our sugared strawberries ready, made into like a thick stew. Next thing you want to do is assemble by putting your cream filling quite thickly on your pie crust. You don't have to get real fancy, just make sure it covers everything really good, because it's part of what makes this taste so good. Put it on the bottom. Layer on some strawberries. Okay, this is the second layer. Put it on top. Add more of the strawberries. Okay, and now we've got the third layer done. Add that. And more strawberries. Now you have to watch how much you put on because it will tend to fill up this pie crust. But you can eat this two ways. You can eat it right now. It makes it very crispy and crunchy, and that's the way I like it. Other people in my family have always liked to let it sit overnight so that the crust soaks up, and then you'll find a lot of the sauce stuff gone in the morning. It will all have soaked into the crust. That's good too. I just like it crispy myself. To decorate the top, you can take a whole strawberry, cut it into slices from the tip down. I always pick the best strawberry I can find, kind of fan it out, and decorate the top. And there you have it. This is my grandma's recipe, Daisy Alexander, and I hope you guys try it and like it. Nobody ever usually has said they've tasted it before, but it's one of our family favorites.